And we welcome you back live to Snohomish High School. We're getting set for tonight's district game, a loser-out game, the Kamiak Knights and the Snohomish Panthers. Ken Roberts joins us here on the broadcast getting set for tonight's game. I'm going to start out with a question I asked Coach Norman. I asked Coach Boyer as well. Do you coach differently tonight being a loser-out game than you would have the other night when you know you're going to play another game?
You shouldn't. We've tried to do the same things all year. We haven't been good at it, but we've tried to. And I think that's the key to coaching is you can't throw something new at them all of a sudden. You might have a wrinkle as far as, you know, strategy, but same coaching approach that we've always had.
Now, before they changed everything, we used to call it at Disneyland that's an e-ticket ride. Boy, you've had an e-ticket ride this whole year on the roller coaster, haven't you?
Yeah, I've got about six more gray hairs, and I've got a name for every one of them. It happens to be a girl's name on her head. And it hasn't been their fault. I mean, it's just been the situation we've been dealt this year. We've had injuries. We still have a senior that's out that, honestly, people don't really know a lot about Mariah Mock, but she would have played some this year had she been healthy with the injuries we had from other kids. She would have stepped right in and never really had a chance to do that. Madison Pollock, Kelly Harwood out for 7 and 8 games right in the middle of the season, and it's been difficult. That week before we played Jackson, we were able to fix some things up offensively. We had some defensive lapses late, and they have very good players that took advantage of any crack we gave them, and they won the game. So I thought we played pretty well last game in a lot of ways.
So the last game on Tuesday night down at Jackson.
Yeah.
Tell us how that game. You had them towards the end, didn't you?
Yeah, about 6:50 to go. I think we're up 5 or 7. They were in the middle of a run, but there'd been runs all game. They'd make a 5 to 7 point run, and we'd answer with – we had an 11-0 run in the first half, had a great third quarter. They had a little run to start the fourth, and then Pollock went down with a knee injury. And you know, it shouldn't have affected us as much as it did, but we had some kids that were very, very affected on the bench. Oh, my gosh, what are we doing out Madison? Crying, tears. It's like, girls, relax. And unfortunately, that didn't happen, and Kingma did what Kingma does and made some big shots.
Right.
How's Madison feeling tonight, Coach? Is she ready to go?
I just saw the video, and I'm surprised she's even able to walk.
They showed it to us, too. I thought Coach Boyer was going to get a little upset about it.
Well, yeah, you know, you look back at Fran Tarkington and stuff of that. I mean, her knee was almost on the dang floor. It hyperextended so far. If it would have been twisted at all, she wouldn't have any ligaments left. So the fact that she came back in that game in the last minute, 40 or whatever, and the fact that she's here today is very, very lucky. And with the season we've had, you wouldn't have expected that, but it's nice to have her back.
Now, Kamiak got you the last time.
Yep.
What could you take from that game to get a win tonight for the Panthers?
Well, hopefully they didn't have Taylor Adcock either, and she's a really good player. We didn't have Callie and Madison. You know, girls basketball, if you were at our tournament over Christmas, we lost the first night to Woodinville, like 50-29, and we won the next two, and they lost the next two. And you look at games, it's so up and down from game to game. And you look at our boys, they lost to Cascade, and then they came out and shot 67% and beat them by 25-30. It's high school basketball, not just girls. But, you know, both teams play good defense. I told our girls before, they're physical. They'll play good defense. They'll rebound. They'll make a game a little ugly because they're not as skilled on offense as a lot of teams. I go, who does that sound like? Us. So it's kind of like a mirror image except for the color of uniforms tonight.
And the coach, you guys are exactly the same age. You went to school together.
Yeah, we went to elementary school together. We hung out at each other's house a lot in elementary, middle school, high school. Yeah, he's a good guy.
So
I'm real excited for
no
Brian.
No secrets.
Yeah, we didn't really talk basketball that much back then. But, you know, it's neat that Brian got the job. He's been there forever. He has been the one constant in that program when they've had a lot of turmoil, about 4 coaching changes, I think, 5 maybe since I've been here.
Right.
And to see the guy that's been always there as the freshman coach or JV coach to get the job and really do a great job this year has been real exciting, especially since I know him.
Yeah. Hey, good luck tonight.
Thank you, guys. Thanks for doing these games. It's great for our girls. It's great for our community. Hopefully we have a few fans show up. It's a little scary.
Yeah.
All right, you guys have a good one.
Good luck.